Well, fall means blooms of summer are fading away, so why are you still sneezing? Fall allergy triggers are different. It can just cause as many symptoms as you have in the spring and summer. Dr. Rob is in the house with tips to get rid of the sneezing. Welcome.
Hello, and I've been sneezing like crazy the last couple
man.
Weeks.
Oh, man, so you have allergies.
I do, but only in the fall, and it's that dreaded ragweed
that
always gets me. That's the culprit in the fall. You know, in the springtime, you get the grasses and the tree pollen, but in the fall, it's the ragweed, and you get the sneezing, the itchy eyes, the runny nose, the cough. Some people have trouble sleeping, and they're just
miserable. Oh, that's awful. Well, and you know, you can kind of tell when somebody has allergies because they don't look like they're feeling good. The bags
the
under the R's,
circle.
The dark circles. So run through some symptoms with us one more time.
Dead giveaway, those dark circles, right?
Okay.
Well, sneezing, itchy eyes, runny nose, coughing, those dark circles under the eyes, of course. Trouble sleeping. Some people get insomnia because they can't breathe. Their nose is so stuffy.
Yeah.
And, of course, living here in the Miami Valley, take a guess where we rank in the top 50 cities in the country as far as fall allergies.
I would think it's not terrible, but
it is.
Really?
We live in a valley,
well,
and we're
true.
Always consistently in the top 10. Dayton ranked number 4.
You're kidding.
Yep, with Louisville, Kentucky beating us out at number 1.
Wow.
But Dayton is always in the top 10. We live in that valley. Whenever you get up in a plane and you're flying overhead, you can see it all just socked in and stuck over the valley.
Everyone's sneezing.
Yep. Too many particles per square inch. Some people don't really have allergies, but they end up with an irritant rhinitis because the volume of irritant ragweed per square inch is so high that it causes all the symptoms. So we have simple things that you can do to alleviate those allergies and help you feel better.
That's a good thing.
The best thing to do, is, if you can do it, is stay indoors during the peak times.
Okay.
About 10 to 3 o'clock during the day is when the ragweed is at its highest concentration. So if you can stay indoors, that will help alleviate the symptoms.
Okay. But if you want to get outdoors, what do you do?
Well, you got to stay well hydrated.
Okay.
That's one of the things to do, because if you stay well hydrated, the nasal secretions are thinner and it's easier to clear things out.
Good news.
Supplements work really well. My two favorite ones to use are vitamin C and then N-acetylcysteine, or NAC, which helps clear out the nasal passages as well. So it inhibits a little bit of that inflammatory response that we get from the allergies. But my favorite and the easiest thing to do once a day is nasal washing.
Okay.
We're not going to make you do that here.
Woo!
But all you have to do is fill this bottle with a little bit of water
and
then one of these packets of the saline solution, and then wash out your nose.
So
one
do you
side
squeeze it, or do you go like this?
No, you do squeeze it. Actually tilt it upside down like this, place it to the nostril, and then what happens, it comes out the other side, and then you use this side. The best thing about this is it's not habit forming. It doesn't have any terrible side effects, and you can use it in your children and as an adult.
Oh, that's a nice
thing. So when your kids are complaining
yeah.
that everything's all stuffy, this is a simple saline solution that washes out the allergens from the nasal passages, and you can't do any harm.
That's a really good thing, especially, you know, you don't know necessarily if your child has a cold or allergies. Real quick, how do we determine what's a cold versus what's allergies?
That's a great question, and what you'll see when their allergies start to turn into maybe they have like a cold or viral infection, all those nasal secretions build up, and from all the hand touching, not washing their hands, touching their face, they can spread viruses and bacteria, and the next thing you know, they've got a sinus infection, maybe bacterial, even viral. What will happen is you'll see temperatures, the headache, the increasing pressure.
Okay.
And now, your kids, you know, they just don't feel good. And what do? They're on the couch. They're down.
They
don't
want
to eat, and they want mama. That's right.
Well, we want Dr. Rob. Where can we find more information on you? Get us all fixed up for our fall allergies.
Alpha Male Medical Institute. That's where we're at.
Awesome. And there it is in Springboro there. You can also call the number at the bottom of your screen or visit americasfitnessdoctor.com. Dr. Rob, thank you so much for being here.
Great to be here.